name of that crew.
It's so great.
I love it. Which coast are you from? The Space Coast.
Space Coast.
All right. So we have some alignment going on here. It looks like the hand is still up for the Detroit Boat Club crew. In terms of point, that hand has gone down. We will see. Quick start. That's what I was going to check and see. And these crews are off. I love to see that quick surge off the front there. Mm-hmm. I saw lane 5 just get that as soon as that mm-hmm. buzzer was heard. They sort of just moved right out.
Would you say that Space Coast has lifted off?
You were waiting for that one. I could tell. I saw you looking at me like, I've got one for this one.
Got to exchange some good dad jokes, you know?
There you go. Well done. All right, so this race is shaping up as our drone returns to the rowers here, the athletes, and the heat of the competition. You can see that the race has started, and all of these boats seem to have remained in contact. So we're within that first 500, which means that you have your start sequence, and then you start to settle, right?
Mm-hmm. And we don't want to say settle. Again, that's kind of a word choice. Yeah.
Some cocks express what's happening. There's so many different terms where you go from being in your start mm-hmm. sequence to your race sequence.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And just word choice and tone and delivery and communication is really important in our sport. So different
from being in your start mm-hmm. sequence to your race sequence.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And just word choice and tone and delivery and communication is really important in our sport. So different crews kind of come up with different that we're talking about with such a flashy name and taken off over there in lane 5. Quick start over there. Red Shell of San Diego Rowing Club also kind of in that mix. White Shell of lane 1, St. Ignatius. Then it is really a toss-up between Capital and Indianapolis, but New Trier actually may be in a third place position. Detroit Boat Club hanging on and still in striking distance of the field.
Yeah, and you can see right now all of these coxswains have good courses. We need to make sure that Capital Boat stays out of those buoys. Once again, you'll probably see a little bit of an adjustment. Don't want to overcorrect, you know. In those cases, mm-hmm. you'll throw the boat off. But right now we're looking across, and this is a great race. You have contact across all of the boats. You have San Diego out by maybe surging into maybe half a boat length there. But the rest of those boats are well in contention for, being the top spot in this race.
Yeah, absolutely. This being a C final in the women's U17, eights, we're fighting for spots 17 through 24 in the country for all these athletes who are 16 and younger. San Diego Rowing Club out in lane 0 trying to break some open water here, but very, very tight. Second place looks to be Capital A, just a hair ahead of St. Ignatius next to them, fighting off Indianapolis for third place. Darker colored shell, still Space Coast is in that mix as well. Every crew, tight racing. I know here in America we've got a very deep field of eights within the youth category, and each one of these crews we've seen familiar programs and names in the youth eights, the men's and women's youth eights, the top eights, not necessarily breaking it down by age. So they just have such a depth of program they can field multiple into breaking them into age categories, getting these young athletes out here. Fantastic to see.
Yeah, and you know, I was looking at Space Coast. I wasn't able to get a rating for them, but it looked like they might have been a little bit higher than their mm-hmm. competitors. So can they maintain that rating as well as that speed through the rest of the course? I think that's going to be the question that we'll have to answer. Right now, it looks like they're doing a great job because they just came through in third place as they came through the 1,000, it looked like.
Absolutely. And all these boats still in contact with each other. Still San Diego Rowing Club in first place, Capital in second place, third, bit of a toss-up, three boats across between St. Ignatius, Indianapolis, and Space Coast. That blue shell of New Trier trying to get in on the action happening in this lead pack.
Yeah, so if you're on the shore, you're wondering why we're calling out the colors of the boats and the colors of the oars. It's because, you know, maybe some people looking for shore can't see. Mm-hmm. It's easy if you're watching it on the stream, but we're calling those out specifically so that, you know, people watching from the shore might be able to tell with the reflection from the water and things like that.
Absolutely. So, and sometimes programs have kind of signature colors.
Yeah.
So I always can recognize San Diego because of their red shells. You see them at a bunch of different regattas in that color. Capital. Wow. Look at them. It was San Diego trying to get a little bit of open water about 500 meters ago, but Capital, they are now, they have overlap, if not halfway through San Diego. Then we're looking at third place. I'd take it to, would we say, Indianapolis, but Space Coast and St. Ignatius making it very, very difficult.
Yeah, you know, and that's the thing right there. You have those three boats that are all pretty close, maybe a half a deck or two seats between them, and they can make moves to try to push each other. And what that's going to do is put some pressure on that capital boat. And if that capital boat can use that as a way to maintain momentum and keep going, then they can actually press that San Diego crew. So we'll see going through the 1500 mark right here, we have San Diego followed by Capital. And now this race continue to press and try to move in a little bit more. And for that race right back there, we have those three boats still battling. We have these boats trying to see who is going to push each other a little bit more. So let's see what's going on here. We have San Diego still out and maybe halting the move from Capital, but not by much. And so this battle for that in that next tier is shaping up right now out in lane five. We have Space Coast starting to take off once again. And now we can see them. They have lifted off, and now we are going blow for blow. They are trying to extend that lead a little bit more over Indianapolis. Indianapolis is responding and starting to move, and along with them is going St. Ignatius. Now, back up in the front of this race, we're going to see what's happened as we enter into this last 250 meters of this race. We have Indianapolis pushing hard. We have San Diego out in front with a hard press from Capital. Can Capital do anything more? It looks like San Diego has said, we are going to halt this move, and they have taken the rating up. Now they are going hard, pushing, driving towards that finish. Can Capital do anything to stop them and gain some more speed? It doesn't look like it, but we're going to see with a couple of strokes left, it looks like San Diego's going to take it. Now Capital is trying to hold off as we have Space Coast pushing hard. They are trying to gain anything back, but it looks like Capital still has open water. Now we have Space Coast coming through, but they will not be held. St. Ignatius trying to push, trying to go a little bit more. And then we have St. Ignatius followed by Capital, was that Capital A? And now crossing the line, we have we have Nutrier, and closing it out, we have Detroit Boat Club.